Morning students, now we'll see the applications of your monostable multivibrator. So we'll see here two applications. One is a frequency divider and the other one is your pulse stretcher. So the frequency divider is your monostable multivibrator can be used as a frequency divider there. So how it can be used as a frequency divider is we can adjust the timing cycle, that is the time period of your output waveform there. So in this case, the time period of the output waveform is going to be varied with respect to the trigger signal of the trigger input signal there, where the trigger input signal is going to be applied to your pin number 2. So how we are going to use this as a frequency divider, as a 2 divide by 2 network circuit, is the timing interval TP, that is the output time period, must be slightly larger than the time period of the trigger input signal there. So if I want to have, so if it is going to be 2 times, so in this case 2 times means, then we can have that it is your TP divided by, that is your input trigger signal divided by your total time period. If the total time period is going to be 2 times larger means, then in that case we can do larger than the trigger period of your input signal, we can use it as a divide by 2 circuit there. If I want it as divide by 3 means, in that case my output time period of the monostable multivibrator 3 times larger than the time period of your input signal there. So we say that the TP must be slightly larger than the twice the period of your input trigger signal. Then we can use this 555 timer as a frequency divider circuit. So here the frequency divider application, it is going to be possible because the monostable multivibrator cannot be triggered during the timing cycle there. So here this is your input signal. When this input signal is going to be given, that is when the input signal and the trigger input signal is going to be less than your 1 by 3 VCC, then we can see that my output of the monostable multivibrator is going to go to the high state there. So in this case, if I want to have it as a divide by 2 network, I should see that this time period should be 2 times of that of the time period of this trigger signal. So the time period of this trigger signal is going to be 0.5, this is going to be 0.6. So 2.5 divided by, here we are going to have it as your 0.6 there. So here in this case, when I am going to have the next trigger signal, the total time period in this case is 0.6 milliseconds. But within this 0.6 milliseconds, I am going to get another trigger pulse to be given at the pin number 2. But your monostable multivibrator will not have any response to this second trigger signal there. Why? Because my output has not come to the low state. So here in this case, this will be avoided and my output will continue to be in the high state. Once this 0.6 millisecond is going to be finalized, my output is going to go to the low state. Again, when my monostable multivibrator will come to the high state is when my input is going to be, that is when the trigger input pulse is going to be below 1 by 3 VCC. So here we can see that this is your one full cycle. So one full cycle is going to be 1 milliseconds there. So here this is your 0.6. This time period, if I am going to see, time period of this trigger input is going to be 0.5. So if I want divide by 2 is 0.5 divided by 1 millisecond is going to be divide by 2 counter. So you can see that a 555 timer can be used as a divide by 2 counter there. So depending upon the width of this pulse, I can decide whether I want divide by 2 or divide by 3. So suppose if I am going to I am going to increase the time period of my output of my monostable multivibrator, I can have this as your divide by 3 counter. Depending upon, so in this case I should see that my output of the monostable multivibrator should be twice that of the trigger pulse, input trigger pulse means it is divide by 2. If it is thrice means it is going to be divide by 3. So this is how we are going to construct your monostable multivibrator as a frequency divider circuit. Your next application of your monostable multivibrator is going to be a pulse stretcher. So pulse stretcher is nothing but the output pulse width. We want to increase the width of the output pulse. If I am going to increase the width of the output pulse, then in that case we say that it is going to act like a pulse stretcher there. So if the output of the pulse width is going to be longer, is of going to be a longer duration, and I am going to consider compare with the negative pulse width of the input signal there. So the output pulse width of the monostable multivibrator can be observed as a stretched version of the narrow input pulse. So we call it as a pulse stretcher there. So here in this case, the narrow pulse width signals are not going to be suitable for driving an LED display there because of the very narrow pulse width. So here the LED may be flashing. So when the LED may be flashing is, it will not be visible to the eye if the time period is going to be very small. If the time period is going to be very small, that time period will not be sufficient enough to drive this LED circuit there. So in that case, I should increase the width of the pulse. If I stretch the width of the pulse, then automatically I can see that the LED to be flashing there. So this is an example of how your 555 timer is going to act as a pulse stretcher. So once when my trigger pulse is going to go below 1/3 VCC, my output is going to be generated to be in the high state. When the output is going to be in the high state, my LED is going to glow there. So here in this case, if my duration of the output waveform is going to be very low, then in that case, the flashing of the LEDs will not be visible. So in order to make the flashing of the LEDs to be visible, I have to make the duration of the pulse width to be more. So the duration of the pulse width is going to depend upon this resistance RA and the capacitance C that is going to be connected between your pin number 7, your discharge transistor, threshold voltage and your ground terminal there. So this is how your 555 timer is going to act as a pulse stretcher. Thank you.